information last night just before, or just after, it should be 8 o'clock at night, that a young black male was driven to local area hospital with a gunshot wound to his abdomen. Unfortunately, he died as a result of those injuries. We simultaneously received 911 calls reporting possible shots fired in an area around Scott Drive and Ellen Place. We were able to confirm that that was the location that the shooting had occurred. Based on the investigation, what we know now is that there was a black or blue, a darkened color Kia K5 sedan that was parked in that area. And the victim, who was later identified as Sadarian, Sadarion Cosby, Cosby, 17 years of age, that young man and three other unidentified individuals walked up, approached that vehicle that was parked. Some type of altercation, incident, conversation transpired. That is part of the investigation that we're trying to determine. Shots were fired. The vehicle fled the area. Two of the three individuals with Mr. Cosby fled the area immediately. One remained to assist Mr. Cosby in getting to like a local, a house that was right nearby with a car. And then that individual fled the area as well. I would like to say that we have reported got reports of information where somebody is sharing video of a vehicle that was taken from the hospital last night. That is not our vehicle of interest. And so we want to make sure that misinformation does not get out there, because we are looking for a dark in color, black or blue, Kia K5 car.
Was that silver car the transport vehicle that took the kid to the hospital?
They were the one that assisted the okay. victim. So they
were the good Samaritan.
Yeah, and we don't want to get that information confused and have that misinformation out there.
I'm sure, but we're at the time absent of any other information.
Absolutely, right.
You see a car being pulled out with a patrol car behind it.
Mm-hmm. And at the same time, you know, we had just arrived on scene and we're trying to figure out, does that car belong and was that car involved? And we were able to determine that it is not considered a suspect vehicle in this investigation.
You say shots were fired. Were shots exchanged or shots just came out of the car?
So that's part of the investigation. Right now it does look like we have two different caliber casings on scene. So that is what we're trying to determine as to who actually shot those rounds, who had the different firearms.
So it could have been an exchange of gunfire between the people who were on foot and the people who were in the car. You just don't know.
Absolutely. That's a possibility, and that's what we're looking into, yes.
The house that they took Sedarian to, did they know this individual? Was it just a random person's house?
That's part of the ongoing investigation. It seems like that's an area, a neighborhood that they're kind of close-knit, so there's a possibility that they knew that person there.
Is this close to where he lives?
That's a good question, and that is absolutely at the core of this investigation. Why were those individuals there? What was the nature of that? So that is a very good question. That is the crux of the investigation right now, is who were those individuals and what were they doing there? And that's where we're asking the public's help. We are looking for the three individuals that were with Mr. Cosby, and we're looking for the individual or individuals that were in that dark in color Kia K5 car.
Do you have any video from any like Ring doorbells or any other security cameras in that neighborhood that you could release to help people try to narrow down who might have been involved?
We have been able to, with the cooperation of some of the residents there, obtain some video footage. They are not ready to release that right now. That's part of the ongoing investigation. If we do find that we need to release that to have the public's assistance in looking at that information and giving us some more information from it, we'll do so.
Is that where the friends are, and have they been located, and are they going to face any charges? Are they teenagers? What's the deal with this?
It's interesting that you use that phrase, friends. I think that's a questionable phrase in looking at what occurred last night. These three individuals were with Mr. Cosby when he received a gunshot wound to his abdomen and was absolutely fighting for his life. They chose to run and worry about themselves instead of assisting him in getting immediate medical attention and then sticking around and assisting us with the investigation. As for what could come for them, that's going to be part of the ongoing investigation and what they were doing there, and absolutely what actually transpired in those moments.
So the three...
No, we're looking for all of them.
I was going to say, the three people who were outside the car.
We're looking for them?
And the really unknown number of people in the car. Everybody's in the wind. You don't have anyone.
Absolutely. We're looking for everybody. So we are looking for the three individuals that were with Sedarian Cosby when he was shot, and we are looking for the individual or individuals. We don't know how many were in that car, in that darkened color Kia K5.
From the surveillance that you've been able to view, could you make out, was there a physical fight in any way? Were there works exchange of any of the cameras had audio, or is it just like you don't know?
Yeah, we don't know. We can capture some aspects of it, but not enough to really have a true depiction right now as to what was occurring right up by that car.
Is Sedarian from Sanford, or where is he from?
I believe that he is from the area.
Have you had previous incidents involving this Mr. Cosby?
I would have to look into that. I don't have any.
But he's not somebody who's well known to your agency.
I would have to look into that. I'm sure I don't want to speak to that.
How much of a challenge does this create with for your investigation when you're not only looking for the three people outside the car, but you're looking for, you don't know how many people were inside that car. I mean, you're looking for multiple people that might have answers in this case.
It does create a challenge. And we're sitting here today talking about a 17-year-old who lost his life last night. And that's a tragedy in itself, let alone to have people that were clearly close with him not care enough to help us find the person that took his life last night. It's challenging and it's heartbreaking at the same time.
Is it? Was there anything in the car, around the car, that suggested what the motive was, drugs or anything, or do you think this was a setup for him?
That's all part of the ongoing investigation, like I said, as to what they were doing there and what all of their intentions were in that moment.
You mentioned a lot of the people that ran. You're still looking for those individuals. Who is cooperating and how have you begun, the information that you do know, how were you able to?
We have been out speaking with neighbors, just what they've heard, what they, again, we've had some that have assisted us with surveillance. We did have the individuals, again, that brought Sedarian to the hospital, so we have been able to speak with them. All of that comes together to create a picture, and hopefully we'll be able to give you guys some more answers soon.
People who gave him a lift to the hospital, do they know him, or were they just picked at random, hey, you got a car, can you take this kid to the hospital?
I believe that there is some knowledge, but I don't have the depth of that.
What does it say about the people that took him to the hospital? Could have said, I don't want any apartments.
We're grateful that they did the right thing. We wish that they didn't have to do that. We wish that this never happened and those people weren't put into that situation, but we're grateful that they did do the right thing and tried to help save Sedarian's life.
Will Sanford police patrolling a little bit more in this neighborhood in the coming days? That's right near Washington Oaks Park. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Let's get dropped off there every day.
Yeah, absolutely. Being proactive in our enforcement efforts is, a very important part of policing, and it's a priority for us. What we do need, though, is the community to come together with us. We can't be everywhere at all times, so we need to work together. And anybody in that neighborhood that has information on these individuals, that's what we need right now, is for them to come forward and work with us and help us bring justice for Sedarian.
What is your message for the community right now?
You've got to, if you know something, you know things are going on in your neighborhood, you need to speak up. And we understand that you may know these individuals and fight that level of maybe giving the police information that could result in them receiving criminal charges. But at the end of the day, it's not acceptable for somebody to lose their lives, to violence on their streets. And that's what you need to think of more, is the victim. There's a life lost here, and everybody needs to step up and do what's right.
Do you have any information on the community itself? Is Sanford Police over there a lot? What is the community like, just in general?
I mean, it's a very active neighborhood as far as, it's a community, So we go through there, we patrol, we're out there doing positive enforcement as well, community outreach. It's a tragedy that this happened right in their neighborhood on their streets.
Thank you.